From Los Angeles, it's the Tom Leykis Show.
Oh, God.
And now, here he is, Tom Leykis.
Thank you for tuning into the Tom Leykis Show. This is where America gets together to talk about the issues you really care about. It's a different kind of a radio talk program. We're the radio talk show that is not hosted by a right-wing wacko or a convicted felon. No, I am your host. Write down our toll-free telephone number. You're going to need it. It's 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. Thank you for tuning in. Thanks for being part of our program. We appreciate it. Ron in Montrose, California, writes in and says, "Hello, Tom. Let me tell you, I know for a fact that girls love the bad boys. I'm one of them. I ride a Harley and I drive a Porsche, and I treat them like dirt, and they still keep coming back for more. They F me and S me." Because S stands for suck. "And I don't call them back. They call me. The $120,000 I make every year doesn't hurt matters either. But I gotta ask you something. I heard a very short excerpt from a recent interview with O.J. Simpson. He was bragging about how he now gets more girls than ever because of his bad boy image. He was chuckling about how women are attracted to that sort of thing. Guys with a reputation for being murderers, etc. I wonder O.J. never sues Jay Leno. Ron goes on to say, "I guess if girls are attracted to the class bully or the Tommy Lees of the world, that's no big deal. But to be attracted to O.J. is more akin to those women in occupied France who are effing all the Nazi officers. Or like Phyllis McGuire whoring herself to Sam Giancana." How old are you, Ron? Ron is 50 minimum. He says, "It's pretty goddamn disgusting. What is it with women who actually want to F some guy strictly because he took a knife and sliced his wife's throat? Or because they gassed Jews? O.J. goes beyond bad boy. He was a bloody murderer. These kind of women deserve the same thing those goddamn French bitches whores got after liberation. To be paraded out and humiliated in public and have their hair shaved off. So what do you think about this whole phenomenon, Tom? What do you think about these effing low-life skank whore sluts goddamn bitches who like to date the OJs and the Gestapo colonels and the mafia hitmen of the world? Don't you think any little bitch who would F O.J. Simpson should get a Malaysian caning?" I think that was Singapore, wasn't it? Yeah. I don't know. Maybe they cane in Malaysia, too. I don't know. He says, "I love the show. Keep him coming. You're actually performing a good service to society. Seriously. Sincerely, Ron." I can't disagree with what Ron is saying here. Might have said it a little differently, but I can't disagree with what he said. I never understand this. It is the reason why I freely talk on the air about how I mistreat women. I don't call them back. I give them backhanded compliments designed to lower their self-esteem. I find various ways to say what appear to be nice things that really are not nice things. I tell them I'll call them back, and then I'll call them back a week or two later. And if they're lucky, they end up with a handprint of mine on their ass. And it pays to advertise, boy, let me tell you. That rings true with a lot of women out there. A lot. They like it. But I believe O.J. Simpson's probably telling the truth in this rare instance. I'll bet he is getting more women than ever. I'll bet you he is. I'll bet there are chicks listening right now who have dated O.J. Simpson or would date O.J. Simpson. What is it with women who, he mentions mafia hitmen. What is it with women who like these mafia movies? Or TV shows like The Sopranos? It isn't because women appreciate intelligent writing. Women love seeing Italian guys standing around going, come here, I'm going to break your face. They like that. The strange thing about this is all of the complaints about domestic violence in our society, and it's certainly a problem. But unfortunately, a lot of women think there's something tantalizing about guys who treat you like crap. Then later on, after you're with them, they really do treat you like crap. Oh, baby, it ain't good. It ain't. So what is it? I mean, maybe there are women out there who can explain why this is, because I'd certainly like to know. Do you believe that, that O.J. Simpson gets more women now than ever? Have you ever dated O.J. Simpson or somebody like him? Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker, remember that guy? He was caught here in L.A. in the late 80s. Murdered all these people. Satanist. Chicks wanted to marry him. They were proposing to him. They were visiting him in prison. O.J. is just one example. Lyle and Eric Menendez, didn't one of them get married in prison? After they killed their parents? That's great. What is it with women like this? I don't get it. And if you're a woman like this, I'd certainly love to talk to you.
Tom Leykis. 1-800-5800-TOM.
Oh.
Tom Leykis.
Hey. I think women would enjoy sex more if they got into
the Tom Leykis Show.
Leykis on Hot Talk 1080 KOTK.
Oh. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Thank you for tuning in. What is it with women and bad boys, and how bad can they be? Ladies, would you date a murderer? Would you date somebody who had done prison time for some violent offense of some kind? What about guys whose past includes domestic violence? We know you do because it happens all the time. But would you dare admit it to me on the air? 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Let's say hi here to Maida on a cell phone. Maida, you're on the Tom Leykis Show.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Maida.
You know, I have some friends that do this. See, what they do is they meet these guys with all these problems, and they say, you know what? I understand why he does it. He just needs some TLC. I understand why he's like this way. I understand why he does all this bad boy stuff. And so they act like they love him. They give him all the love attention they can because they understand him. They love him. And then 2 days later, they're getting beat up, shot up, everything. And then they ask me why. They don't understand why he's doing that.
Yeah. I mean, what woman goes out with O.J. Simpson? And you know he's getting dates.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Who goes out with him? This guy? Come on. Hello.
But they believe it. They sit there and say, you know, I understand him. I understand where he's coming from. And that's all they need is understanding and a little TLC. And then when she ends up dead, then the family's like, we don't understand what happened. What happened?
I'd love a woman who would go out with a guy like that to call in. And, you know, O.J. has lived in L.A. Most of the last 20 years. He's been living in Florida recently, but he lived in L.A., has spent time in L.A. I'd love to talk to a woman who has dated O.J. Simpson since 1994. Just one.
I'd slap a woman who dated O.J. Simpson. I'd slap her silly. So, like, what the heck are you doing?
Really?
You know? But that's what everyone, I mean, that's what they want. That's what they want. But they're going to get it.
Thank
they
you.
Come back crying. Just don't come crying to me because I don't want to hear it.
Thank you, Maida. 1-800-5800-TOM. Lynn, you're on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hi. How you doing, Tom?
Do you care, Lynn?
Yes, I do.
I'm doing great.
Good. I'm glad to hear it. As far as women who do date guys like that, I spent 3 years dating the guy who did beat me up. But thank God for my husband now. He did save me from that.
But why did you do it?
It's all because of self-esteem. Self-esteem and self-assurance. They cannot find anybody else who will sit there and tell them, oh, honey, you're the best, you're the greatest, oh, I love you. And then they'll turn around and snack up and say, oh, I'm sorry, you'll never have it again, and do it again. It's all because the women who date guys like that don't have enough self-control and self-image, and basically they have no self-esteem and confidence in themselves to stand up to people like that. And if they do have the confidence to stand up with people like that, then they wouldn't be with them in the first place. And if somebody did date somebody like that, then...
Well, how in the world did your husband, if it's all about self-esteem, how did your husband rescue you? It sounds like the same syndrome all over again.
He gave me the strength enough to leave the guy that I was seeing. To say, okay, hey, you know, you're better than that. You don't need that. Look into yourself and say...
Well, why did you believe him when he said it and not yourself?
He gave me the strength enough to find out in myself that I did.
It just sounds to me like you are defined by whatever man is with you.
No. He was my best friend before we started dating.
Hmm.
And he didn't tell me what to do. Right? He was going through problems of his own. But being with him as a friend gave me the strength enough to leave the guy that was hurting me. To say, hey, you know, like a wake-up call.
I see. All right, Lynn, thank you. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Mark on a cell phone. Mark, you're on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. How you doing?
Okay.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. Hey, you know what? Basically this whole domestic violence thing and you know, beating of women, I myself used to be a nice guy until I dated the wrong woman who cost me my job in law enforcement because of the fact that the one time where she just did not know when to shut her yap, just kept going and going and going, you know what? I had to let loose on her. You know what I did? I pushed her. So she goes over and dials 911. The police show up. I have to identify myself as a law enforcement officer. And because she had a mark on her chest, I end up getting arrested. I eventually lose my job. And all because this woman who has no self-control whatsoever, no self-esteem whatsoever, decides to go off on me because I was out with the guys. And basically, I mean, you've got to keep people in line sometimes. It's like I'm dating some of these women. They're like little kids.
So when you say you've got to keep them in line, what are you proposing we do?
Well, what I'm proposing is this. Okay. Now, I'm not for, keep in mind now, I'm not for going out and starting to kill women or, you know, parade them out, like that letter writer said, into public and shave their heads. But come on, you got to give us a little bit of leeway. Let's go back to Gone with the Wind, that famous scene where Clark Gable slaps that chick who was giving him too much lip. I mean, do that nowadays, and guess what happens? You go to jail, even though she deserved it. Can't do that anymore.
So you think we should change the law to allow men to slap women in the face?
Serve it. I mean, keep in mind, for every woman that gets slapped is one that didn't know when to just shut up. And I mean, that's just the bottom line. I mean, corporal punishment has been taken out of schools, and it's just a continued vaginification of America.
Mark, hang on here a second, because we have some women who want to talk to you. Would you hang on?
Absolutely.
All right, we're going to get to those women in a couple of minutes, but we'll take a couple of calls in the meantime. If you want to talk to Mark, you know the number, 1-800-5800-TOM. It's John on a cell phone. You're on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hello, John.
Hello, John.
How you doing?
Okay.
All right. I just want to say, dude, you're great.
Thank you.
Work tolerable, buddy. All I do is drive around all day and listen to you.
Good.
I just have one thing to say about the whole bad boy image thing, is that, you know, all my buddies, they dress up in these nice shirts and all this and do their hair, and, you know, I go out and pierce some stuff and get some tattoos, and I get way more tail than any of them do.
Now, do you just look bad, or are you bad?
Nah, it's not that, like, I don't know, I kind of look the part more than I play.
You just look the part.
Yeah, you can look the part and then play the nice guy and you get it all.
And they don't mind if you just look the part.
No, they
You don't actually have to go out and kill anyone.
No. None of that stuff.
You don't have to actually slap him in the face like Mark advocates.
No way. I would never do that.
Mm-hmm.
Never touch a woman.
And you get more women this way.
More women than anybody
else. Do they think you're as bad as you look?
It's not. Yeah, it's just, you know, they look. You look rough and just look like a tough guy, and they go for it.
That's all it takes.
Warm and, you know, they go for it.
John, thank you for that. It's Josh on a cell phone. You're on the Tom Leykis Show.
Hey, what's going on, Tom?
Not much, Josh.
I was just thinking because I'm kind of like the guy that the girls always talk to, too, you know? And it's so funny when they talk, oh, well, you know, he hit me the other day, or, you know, he's going out with another girl, you know, how they always end with by saying, but he loves me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just like...
Or better yet, but I love him.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't mean to do it, Tom. Honest. I just think that's the funniest. I mean, so really, I think girls would go out with any kind of guy, even if they know, like you said, OJ. Girls go out with him, and you should know that this man has killed his last wife.
I'm just amazed, though. Even if you don't know for sure, why would you take a chance?
It is. It's pretty nuts, man. I just want to call and say, what up, Tom? You the man. And if you could take me out with a bong rip and a thank you, Jesus.
All right, here it comes. You ready, Josh?
Thank you, Jesus.
It's George on a cell phone. You're on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
What's up, Tom?
Not much, George.
What's up?
Not nearly enough.
Man, long-time listener, first-time caller, man. Listen, I'm calling, man. You know, I think just what it bottomed down to, man, I think women just need to get slapped. They just need to be told what's up, be dominated, and they're only put on earth for one thing, and that's just my sex, man. That's just it.
Oh, come on. You're just saying that. You don't believe that. You're just saying that.
I seriously dare
you. You just want to sound like a big man on the radio. Come on. You don't mean that.
I am not a big man, man. But I'm just telling you like it is. You know, women deserve, man, one thing, man. Especially in bed. Tell me they don't like to get slapped.
Woman
out there that doesn't like to get the old slap on the ass cheek in the bed.
Well, wait a minute. There's a difference between a slap on the ass cheek and a punch in the face.
Oh, no punch to the face, man. I didn't say punch to the face. I say get smacked. I don't punch to the face, man. I'm not like that.
Yeah, well...
Like, 'cause 101 doesn't teach me that.
Right. I mean, we're not talking about the kind of consensual slapping that goes on in bed. We're talking about a guy says, shut your yap, and the woman says, no, F you, and then he slaps her.
Oh, well, you know, in the bed, you know, it kind of gives you a little bit more leeway to kind of slap them where you shouldn't, but you know how it is.
Hmm.
You know, I mean, that's just the way it is. You know, women nowadays, you know, it's all about them. It's all about, you know, all this abuse crap. And, I mean, like one time I had a girlfriend, man, I got like a little domestic dispute. I didn't hit her at all. And, you know, she calls the cops, and then she's sitting there screaming and crying. And guess who gets hauled off? Boom, one day in L.A. County Jail.
The guy always gets hauled off.
That's crap, dude.
Yeah.
That's crap.
Even if the guy is all bruised and bitten and beaten, he gets hauled off.
I think if a guy's going to seriously sit up and punch a woman out in the face, yeah, you know, he deserves to get, you know, what's coming back at him. But, you know, I'm just saying, you know, in the bed, you know, women kind of like that little hit in the back of the head.
No, is that so? Right. 1-800-5800-TOM. Coming up, we're going to talk to Mark, the ex-cop who thinks women ought to be slapped.
The Tom Leykis Show.
Tom Leykis. Only.
It's the Tom Leykis Show.
From Los Angeles at 1-800-5800-TOM. All right. On the line we have Mark, a former police officer, who believes that we ought to change the laws to allow men to give a woman a good slap in the face because sometimes they just don't know when to shut their yaps. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Here's Lisa on the Tom Leykis Show for Mark. Hello, Lisa.
Hey, Tom. How's it going?
Hi, Lisa.
First-time caller, 3-month listener.
Cool.
This guy is a moron. What's wrong with him? That's why he's not a policeman anymore. Hasn't he ever heard of count to 10 or walk away? You know, get out of the room. Don't talk anymore. When somebody's talking too much, walk away.
See, that's my point. If she's in front of me, I would just have to backhand her.
Oh, well, then you know what? Be lucky that I'm not your woman, because if you had backhanded me, I'd kick you right in the nuts.
I don't think so.
Oh, I know so. Oh, believe me. I highly doubt it. Oh, believe me. That's
hey, Lisa, let me ask you a question. If two men get into a fight, Okay, does one of them deserve to go to jail or both deserve to go to jail?
That's a good question, but it depends.
No. Answer the question. Does one of them deserve to go to jail or both of them deserve to go to jail?
Whoever it is that chose not to walk away from the situation deserves to go to jail.
Okay,
not unless it was the person who was defending themselves should not go to jail.
The person defending themselves should not go to jail?
No.
Okay, so why is it that if a woman is physically assaulting a man and a man defends himself and in the process of defending himself hits the woman, keep in mind, from a defensive posture, why should he go to jail?
Because, first of all, most men outweigh a woman anywhere from 100, maybe even 150 pounds, okay? I mean, as much as I hate to admit it, being that I am a woman, I'm a single mother, I'm a homeowner, I have two children, I'm sole supportive of both my children, okay? A man, if I came to a physical confrontation with a man, I'm going to do the best I can to hurt him the way he's hurting me. But odds are, he's going to hurt me really bad, right, Mark?
Wait a second. Okay,
right,
so wait a second.
No. So you're going to try to hurt him.
Wait a minute. You're going to try and hurt him.
To make him stop hurting me.
Okay, that's what we were talking about. We were talking about a point where a man is in a defensive posture, a defensive position. Okay, does that mean you're going to be in a defensive posture or position? No, you just said you were going to try and inflict pain on him.
Okay, no.
And why are you a single mother?
We're talking about defending. Why are you a single mother? Why am I a single mother? Because I married a deadbeat dad.
I
married a person who couldn't keep his unit in his pants. That's the reason why.
His unit in his pants.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So would you rather have had him hit you or keep his unit in his pants?
Actually, I probably wouldn't have. I would have walked away from both.
You would have walked away from both?
Exactly.
I don't know, Tom. I don't know. I mean, here's the bottom line. If you and I got into an argument, and it was just a verbal argument and stayed a verbal argument, that's okay. But when you start to get personal, when you start to inflict, shall we say, a verbal abuse that could be a lot more devastating than a physical abuse, then you deserve to be put in line. And if verbally putting you in line doesn't work, then you know what? You deserve to get slapped. And that's all there is to it. It's just, I mean, think about this for just a minute. Have men ever used words on you that were more hurtful than someone, say, pushing you?
Yes.
Or slapping you in the arm?
Yes. All right, Lisa, thank you. Jared, you're on the Tom Leykis Show with Mark.
Hey, first-time caller, two-year listener. How in the hell are you going to try and tell anybody that slapping a woman is okay?
Well, me telling people that slapping a woman is okay made you call in for the first time in 2 years.
Because I can't stand guys who hit women. You can't
really
control a situation.
Then you know what, buddy?
Then walk away from it.
You're going to get taken advantage of. I tried to walk away from my situation.
Walk away from us. If she
I have walked away from her. I didn't marry her. I said she was my girlfriend.
You're in the situation with her. Don't put yourself in the situation.
I took myself out of the situation. But just remember, you know what? You mark your own words, my friend, because I used to think just like you. And you know what? There's always someone that comes along that's maybe just a little more well-versed, a little bit better at being abused and knows how to work the system. And keep in mind, someone's going to push your buttons, Jared. I pushed your buttons. I made you call for the first time in 2 years.
Hey, you know,
pushing your buttons right now.
Hey, 8 months ago, I took a baseball bat to the forehead from a girl, from a blind side. And I still didn't hit her back.
Well, because you were probably
because
knocked out cold on the ground.
You can't hit women, bro.
Because you were probably knocked out cold on the ground.
You can't pin her down. You can't hold her down. You have to push her. You can't defend yourself.
Wait a minute. So you're okay with pushing a girl? You're okay with pushing a girl?
No. I'm not saying
you just said.
Just
you just said.
Protect you
just said to push the girl. You just said
to
push the girl.
You don't have to push her. You don't have to slap her.
You
don't have to do anything.
You see, here's the difference between you and I. You got knocked so far upside your head that you think it is completely skewed. I didn't get hit upside my head with a bat.
The time, though.
Who's the punk?
I've been slapped before. I've been pushed. I've been kicked.
You see my point, Tom?
You just walk away from it, bro.
You know what?
Put yourself in the situation.
You know what? You've got a vagina down there.
No, you've got a vagina, bro. You think it's okay to hit another woman, you're the pussy. You're the typical guy in high school that couldn't take control of a situation, couldn't push around who you wanted to push around, so you became a cop so you had the power to do it.
I don't.
And then
you
lost your job because you couldn't control a woman. That's what happened.
You know
what,
you're
have
right.
A vagina.
You're right. I couldn't control it, but you know, what does it mean the guy hit upside the head with a bat?
It doesn't.
Who's the punk?
That's
the punk?
I'm not saying that. That's right.
Who's the punk?
I'm just saying you still don't deserve to hit somebody.
Who's the punk? Hey, you know what? I don't. What, you think I just walk up to women in the street and slap them upside the head?
No, but if she's talking too much, then walk away.
No, if she's talking too much and you try to walk away, and that you got to.
I mean, I deal with
something.
Customers all day.
That
they talk too much.
Legs.
I don't slap them.
Well, that's a business. You're not dating your customers, are you?
Either, yeah, that's the, I'm getting paid to be there.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? You're going home to it. Walk away. Walk out of the house. Don't come home if you don't like you being out with your friends.
Hey, you know, brother, it's my house. Hey, you know
don't
what?
Come home.
A man's home is his castle.
They kick her out of your house, or don't let her move in.
I didn't let her move in.
She's a crazy bitch, and she's going to hit you. Then so
I didn't let her move in. And, you know, and let me just tell you this. You know what, Jared? You've been, let's see, you said you've been slapped, kicked, hit upside the head by a baseball bat. What else? Kicked in the nuts. Was that another one? What else
is
happening?
Those are normal species. They're different.
Well, they're different.
You have the right to slap them.
They're different. You know what? If you would have slapped one person one time and kept them in line, you wouldn't keep getting abused. You're an abuse victim.
All right, Jared, thank you for the call.
Tom Leykis.
1-800-5800-TOM.
Tom Leykis.
1-800-5800-866. The Tom Leykis Show.
Leykis on...
The Tom Leykis Show. 1-800-5800-TOM. Continuing with Mark. This is Sherry on a cell phone. Sherry, you're on the Tom Leykis Show with Mark. Hello.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
Pretty good.
That's great. So I want to know, does this guy have, like, a girlfriend now?
Yes, I do.
Oh, you do, do you?
Yes,
and
I do.
Is she ever allowed to speak?
You know what? I've got 3 girlfriends.
Oh, great, great. Well, you know what I think your problem is? You
Tell
know,
me.
I lived with a guy like you for 10 years. And after the 3rd time of him beating the crap out of me, I said, you know what? That's enough. And you know why he did it? He did it because he said I was too independent. Well, you know, if independent is standing up for yourself and voicing your opinion, then women do not need women, men like you. And you want to know what else? I was the one that got called on. I had to go to jail. I had to sit in a cell overnight because I dropped a book that accidentally hit his toe after he broke my nose. And then in the divorce, I'm the one that got screwed. So don't feel sorry for yourself because, oh, poor baby lost his job. You know, it happens to women, too, and I just cannot believe that you can go on the national air and think you're all that, because you're not.
I never said I was all that. I said,
well, you're sitting there saying that. You're sitting there saying, oh, women, when they go off on themselves, they should be slapped. So I'm guessing you want to slap me right now.
No, because honestly, you don't. No, you know what? You're free to voice my opinion, and you don't matter to me. So because you don't matter to me, you're not going to incite me to slap you across the face, because of the fact I'm not going to need to resort to any type of physical violence to outwit you.
Oh,
let
so
me just put it to you like this.
So people,
hey, Sherry, let me put it to
you
like this. No, I didn't say I loved her. I left her immediately after that happened. And you know why I have 3 girlfriends right now?
Why?
The reason why I have 3 girlfriends right now is because of the fact that, one, I don't hit them or abuse them, but you know what? They know where they stand with me. And
they know that if they get
out
of line, you're going to slap them.
No, you know, actually not. You know what it is?
To get our way?
Absolutely not. You know what? Why? The reason why they're not scared of me. They're not scared of me at all. But you know what? Mutual respect. It sounds to me like you were in a relationship where there was no respect. If you're going to sit there and tell me that you got hauled off to jail because you dropped a book on his toe, I can tell you right now that you are absolutely wrong, because that's like you telling me that, well, you know what, I accidentally dropped a book on his face and broke his nose, so you went to jail because of the fact that you abused him.
Thank you, Sherry. Maria, on a cell phone, you're on the Tom Leykis Show with Mark. Hello.
Hi, Tom. I love your show. I'm a first-time caller.
Thank you.
Mark, why aren't you a cop anymore? Were you fired, or?
No, what happened was this. I got the option of either serving a 45-day suspension for what's called conduct, and
they call you, or what happened?
No, what happened was this. I was out with some friends after work, and we got home about, two of my friends, we got home about 1:30 in the morning, and I wasn't drunk, so I wasn't out drinking.
Mm-hmm.
We were just hanging out after work, and she had, as a matter of fact, she was the one that was intoxicated when I got home, and she just started to accuse me of cheating on her and lying to her and everything else. Well, at that point, I said, you know what, you're completely wrong. So she went and sat down in the other room. My friend said, you okay? I said, yeah, I'm all right. So they left, and so it was just her and I in the house, and I wasn't going to go to bed with her that night, so I went, picked up my pillow, my blanket, and was going to go to the couch and sleep, and she followed me all the way out to the couch. And I said, listen, just leave me alone. So she started just calling me all kinds of names and just going off on me. And then she started throwing things at me.
What does this have to do with you being fired?
Well, I'm getting to that right now. So what ended up happening is she started destroying my property. So I went over and I grabbed her and told her to stop. And she spit in my face. So I slapped her across the face.
You deserve that.
I deserve that.
What police department did you work for?
I'm not going to tell you that. But so what ended up happening? So what ended up happening is the police come out. They see all this property destroyed.
A real man doesn't hit a woman.
Excuse me, but a real woman would pause. You know, let me tell you something.
You're a pussy, Mark.
I am.
A real man does not hit a woman.
Uh-huh.
Why don't you hit the wall if you're pissed off? Hit yourself.
Let me ask you a question.
You deserve to have your penis cut off.
Have you ever, you deserved a vaginal circumcision. Have you ever, see, look at you. Already getting full of you.
You're not a man.
Why are you cussing?
You're not a man,
Why are you
buddy.
Cussing? You're angry. Why are you so angry? I was talking to you in a very
Everything
even tone,
in a Tom's
telling you
right
what
now,
happened.
I'm probably angry at you.
I highly doubt it. But listen to yourself. Listen
Why
to how
would
you're
you
going
you're
off.
From, then? What are you afraid of?
But listen to how you're going off. Have you been hit?
Never. And my husband's a police officer. He would never lay a hand on me.
Well, obviously not.
Me, ever.
Obviously not. I mean, listen to you. You deserve a slap across the face. You're out of control.
Whatever.
Exactly.
Well,
how do you sleep at night? You're an apple.
All right.
I sleep at night very well.
Maria, thank you very much for the call.
Tom Leykis.
1-800-5800-TOM.
Tom Leykis.
1-800-5800-866.
What you need is you got two women there, right? So when you're done, they can cuddle, and you can go out and make a sandwich while they just sit there cuddling. I don't watch the game.
Or I'll tell you what kind of sandwich I'm going to make. I'm going to make a Tom sandwich between two slices of chick.
The Tom Leykis Show.
Tom Leykis.
Tom is our telephone number. We have Mark, and we have Elizabeth on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi.
How are you?
Do you care?
Yes, I do.
I'm doing great. Say hi to Mark.
Hi, Mark.
Hi.
Tom, you're usually so opinionated, and you're saying so quiet.
Because Mark speaks for himself. I'm letting him do it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tom. I appreciate it.
I am actually probably in the... I'm on Mark's side. Wait, before anything, though, I believe that relationships should be based on mutual respect. And then I'm tired of women trying to use their defenselessness as a right to be able to physically assert themselves on men and not expect something in return.
Thank you. Finally, someone who makes sense.
Yes.
Finally.
Actually, you know, I don't think it's right for any physical violence. You know, any domestic violence is wrong. However, I do believe that if, you know, women like me want to be independent, then I think we should also, you know, feel that we have to give, it's common courtesy, it's respect. You know, I don't think that women should be over here saying, well, if a woman hits a man, then it's okay because she's weaker. I'm actually pretty strong for my size, so I think I could actually cause damage if I wanted to and intended to.
Hang on a second, Elizabeth. I have Darla here. Darla, what did you want to say here to Elizabeth?
How can you sit there and say that it's okay?
Let
me ask you a question. Has a guy ever hit you out of anger, out of no reason?
No, because I never physically get up in his face. I don't in his personal space.
Well, Mark's not saying that. He's saying that, you know, if he doesn't like what you say, he's going to hit you.
That's not what I said. Not even close. That is the way that you are. It's okay to hit her. That is the way you are interpreting it. Now,
really?
Let me ask you something. Do you ever go out clubbing per se?
Yeah.
Do you ever go out to a club? Okay.
Absolutely.
Has a girl to you made a snide comment or said, "Girl, you're just all dressed like a slut in hell." A girl ever said that to you?
Actually, no, a girl would never say that to me.
Why wouldn't she say that
to you? Because I don't set myself up for that.
Okay. Now, what if a girl just came up